Hello, and welcome to the vCloud Automation Center video, Automated Network Provisioning with NSX Overview. In this video, we are going to show you how vCloud Automation Center exposes, provisions, and consumes NSX constructs. While NSX has the capability to integrate with many different platforms, this video will be dealing specifically with NSX for vSphere. Today, the world revolves around applications. Creating, delivering, and managing those applications is a formidable challenge for IT. By virtualizing all aspects of the data center, namely compute, networking, security, and storage, VMware customers are moving to a completely virtualized infrastructure, one that can be dynamically configured to meet specific application needs. Because a virtualized infrastructure is fully abstracted from hardware, workloads running in your data center can be deployed seamlessly on the environment of your choosing, be that private cloud, public cloud, or a hybrid cloud. Management is the catalyst that empowers the software-defined data center. VMware's vCloud Automation Center accelerates the end-to-end delivery of infrastructure, applications, and custom IT services through the dynamic configuration of these virtualized services. In this video, we are going to explore how vCloud Automation Center simplifies and accelerates the deployment of NSX logical network and security services as part of a multi-tier application deployment. Today, applications need much more than just appropriately sized virtual machines. They also need networks configured with appropriate connectivity, security, availability, scale, and performance. vCloud Automation Center can dynamically provision NSX logical services customized to the specific needs of each application. As part of deploying a complex multi-tier application, vCloud Automation Center improves connectivity through deployment of logical switches and networks. It improves security through the intelligent placement of workloads into security groups protected by dynamic firewall rules. It also increases availability and performance of your applications utilizing NSX distributed firewalls and load balancers. Now that you understand the value this solution delivers, let's look at the configuration steps required to automate the delivery of secure, scalable, and high-performing multi-tier applications. The infrastructure administrator is the person who defines the managed endpoints that are required to interact with and discover infrastructure resources. vCloud Automation Center discovers and manages the underlying compute fabric through the device manager that manages those resources. To communicate with these device managers, the administrator defines managed endpoints for each of the virtual, physical, or public cloud device managers. This sets up the initial discovery as well as ongoing discovery, which happens daily by default. NSX Manager is configured as a subset of your vSphere endpoint, and when the appropriate credentials are defined, discovery of NSX resources is enabled. Network profiles perform two primary functions. Firstly, network interface configuration. These settings apply equally to virtual machines and NSX Edge Services routers as part of a multi-machine blueprint deployment. The second part is the NSX Edge Services Router configuration. Depending on the type of network profiles you have defined within your multi-machine blueprint, several rules will be configured on the NSX Edge Services Router during deployment. These rules determine how your application networks will interact with external networks, potentially routing, NATing, or dropping traffic. In a more complex deployment, more than one rule set may be configured dynamically during the provisioning process. Security groups are created in NSX Manager by your security team in accordance with your corporate policies and allow for dynamically provisioned workloads to inherit the security policies that are associated with these security groups. Security policies include traditional rule sets such as allowed services and source destination rule sets, but can also include endpoint services such as antivirus, vulnerability management and data security, as well as network introspection services. In combination, these provide a powerful suite of security services for your applications. vCloud Automation Center will discover these security groups when it runs a data collection against your NSX manager, at which point they can be assigned to a multi-machine blueprint. When a user requests a catalog item through the service catalog, the provisioned workloads will be added to the defined security groups with no input required from the requesting user. Reservations are responsible for defining the storage and compute resources that are available to a given business group. Apart from the storage and compute resources, reservations are also responsible for the placement of virtual machines and NSX edge services routers onto the appropriate port group or logical switch through network path settings. They also handle the request and allocation of network details from the appropriate network profiles to these virtual machines and edge services routers. Knowing that, there are three key configuration areas that we need to specify within a reservation for dynamic network provisioning: the external network to associate with the defined network path, the transport zone, which edge services routers will be a member of, and finally, the router gateway to which routes will be advertised in the event of using a routed network profile. Having defined your network profiles and reservations, the final step in this process is to configure your multi-machine blueprint. You'll need to identify one or more single machine blueprints to include as components of your multi-machine blueprint. Secondly, you will need to select the appropriate transport zone information as provided by your NSX administrator. Thirdly, select the network profiles which you wish to use with your blueprint components. Finally, identify any NSX security groups which you wish your blueprint VMs to inherit security policies from. Once this is done, you are ready to publish your application blueprint and allow users to request it from the service catalog. This completes our overview of vCloud Automation Center Automated Network Provisioning. To get additional information and demonstrations that show the steps required to configure your environment to take advantage of these benefits, please see Managing Network Profiles for NSX Integration and Preparing vCloud Automation Center for NSX Integration. These two videos will provide deeper demonstrations of the configuration steps required to set up your environment for vCloud Automation Center and NSX integration. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We hope that it was informative.